about seismic data processing. So in this seismic data processing, first we have to understand what is the seismic data processing. The data processing is a sequence of mathematical operations which are carried out to extract useful information from the raw seismic data. The basic objective of this seismic data processing is the useful information which we would like to collect from the field, that is in the raw form actually, and to improve the signal to noise ratio, which has been given here, the processing of reflection data. Normally we are using three type of seismic during exploration of hydrocarbon, which is the refraction, diffraction and reflection. But mostly for seismic data processing and seismic data imaging of the subsurface of the formation, we are using the reflection data. The basic objective of all the seismic data processing is to convert the information recorded in the field into a form that can be used for geological interpretation. And subsurface geology, the seismic section which represent the subsurface geology as truly and clearly as possible. The any success of a seismic exploration is largely depends upon the quality of the seismic data, no doubt. So we are having the raw data, we have to process the data in the next slide we can understand these three pictures, in which the first picture is showing the raw data and the second picture is showing the seismic section, and third picture is showing the geological formation or the geology of the area. So the main objective of this seismic data processing is to produce the seismic section representing the geology of the formation first. And second, the most important objective of this seismic data processing is to improve signal to noise ratio, which has been given here. And third is to explore the objective of the client or target and our prospect, which can be known as prospect. So we have to identify the prospects also. In the second number, the isolation of wanted signals, a reflection isolates from the multiple surface waves, because we are our the main target is to the wave which has been generated by a source which will be traveled through the medium and reflected from a particular horizon and it will again reach data receiver. When it will reach data receiver, then the information it will give the information about the horizon or a acoustic impedance which has been reflection has taken place for a particular depth, to obtain a high resolution by adopting the waveform of the signals, to obtain a realistic image by geometrical correction, to obtain information about the subsurface and the result of processing of the data. Here the first and second, it is a comparison between the raw data and processed data after migration. It has been looking better resolution, and it can be used for geological horizon identification and structures both. And this slide is shown the basic scheme of seismic data processing, and these are the steps which is being used for seismic data processing. Then first step is loading the data and conversion. If you see the data we are getting through acquisition from the field, and there is an acquisition geophysical team which is acquire the data from the field and send it to the workstation where data is being processed for this means seismic data processing. And second step, this is called pre-processing, because these all the steps are being used here as a pre-processing, because processing is being started from here. These are the data format we are getting from the data field, and when it will be in SAG D or SAG Y format, and it will be the acquisition geometry information, sort receiver coordinates, static correction, offset, short depth elevation, etc. Data is being loaded in a processing system. Okay, then the next step will be demultiplexing. Then one by one we will discuss these each and every steps in the next few slides. Here first is the pre-processing. So recording media is being in the earlier we are using this type of hard disks, okay, and it is the oldest hard disk in 1956 is being used by IBM. Okay. We can see how it's looks like. Then reflection seismic is the tap will be first demultiplexed and then display in this form. This will be the suppose bad traces will be enumerated at editing, and then muting lineup means it will be NMO correction. Then stacking is called summation of the three traces. Then shrink, display and interpretation, these are the main steps.